I think the market in 2013 was quite good. We had a good business coming from the previous year. I think after the crisis in 2009, the worldwide market established and grew very well. And in 2013, we had a very good year. In general, we can say the second best year of the Carmayer history. This was also the case in Turkey. In Turkey, we were also quite happy about our business. We had a good distribution in different machinery types, and the warp knitting industry is a growing industry in Turkey, and we are happy to participate in that.
Before, I want to say also something about beaming preparation for our global market position. Since we had this cooperation or takeover of the Benninger company, the Benninger beaming preparation and former Zucker Müller technology, it was the best year of Carlmayr. We are very satisfied with this result. And we hope we can continue on this level.
As I just said, we had a good order coming from the previous year. Also from 2013, we had a good order backlog. The first half of the year, we were serving this backlog, and then the Turkish market was slowing down a bit. I think it was mainly related to the political situation and the uncertainty for entrepreneurs to continue their investments. But now, after the election being completed and giving a positive indication for the business side, people continue their investments, and the indication of the last week was quite positive. So we expect to have a fairly good year in Turkey. And if we look at our Turkish market in comparison to other markets, Turkey was always the last 4 years in the top three of our main markets, and I think it will continue like this, and we are quite optimistic that we can continue our business.
The market expectation for Turkey in 2000, I want to start with 2013. Also in Turkey, 2013 was the best year ever for Carlmayr in the beaming preparation. And it will be hard, but we work on it to get more or less the same result in 2014.
Yes, Carlmayr is distributed in three main business units. It's the warp knitting side, the warp preparation side, which is represented by Mr. Roth, and we have the technical textile side. I'm in charge of the sales for this area in the warp knitting field, and we can say that this has been in the past our main market and is continuing like that. Okay, after the crisis or the weaker period around 2009, we have had a very strong and stable market over the past years, and the focus in warp knitting is tricot machinery, especially for the home textile sector as an embroidery ground. We also do serve the sportswear market, and then we have the other field of multibar machines and jackup machines, which mainly go in curtain market, home textile market, and also in the fashion outerwear market. So this is the main focus in this region for us.
In beaming preparation, we had since the last 3 years, a big request in traditional sizing and warping machines, and we could enter the Turkish market with our first Indigo slasher lines. And since we entered in Turkey with Indigo, the market or the request for Indigo, for denim fabric, is very high. We hope we can continue with this, but for the long time future, we are also expect that sectional warping and even the filament will come back or will come to Turkey.
We can also say that our customers are getting more and more share in export. In earlier days, it was more on the local market. It was a local consumption of warp knitted fabric. But we can see that, especially in the fields of upholstery and curtain, we can see that more and more is going into exports, whether it's Eastern Europe or also in the Arabic countries. So export has grown rapidly, and we work very close together with our customers to find new products, to find new innovative products for them, also to be competitive against the Far East market. I think this is the main challenge also.
In beaming preparation, it's easy to say. Most of our customers are top-class customers, making a very high brand fabric, especially in denim. I would say the export rate is more than 70% of this customer, and they are at least taking over the market from Italy and from others. Turkey will be the number one in Europe, of course, for denim.
As I said before, we have our own business unit for the technical textile application. We must say that in Turkey it's still in very early stages, the technical textile production. So we have our focus on that, but the share remains still very small. But we continue, and especially we take platforms like this, like exhibitions, symposiums, to give more input to our customers, and we can see that more and more demand is coming, but it's still taking time. But we are keeping a clear focus on that.
From the weaving preparation, I can say Turkey is a textile country, not a country for technical textile. So you are so strong in standard classical fabrics that technical textile is not a question here in Turkey yet. It will come for special things, but the main production in Turkey will remain clothing.
As a market leader, it's always difficult to maintain the position. So I think most important is our focus on development. So we continuously develop new products in the warp knitting field in our headquarters in Obertshausen. But we don't focus only on price performance. So we can make machines faster and more efficient. But I think we have other responsibility also to our customers, that we develop new products and new applications for this. And I think in Turkey we have very close relationships to our customers, so we get a lot of response from them, and based on this we can develop new products. But sure, we have just recently introduced a new two-bar tricot machine, and it's the first two-bar electrical machine which was running 5,000 RPM. So we can see that we are feeding both requirements, the price performance side and also the new application field side.
For beaming preparation it's much easier because we are only preparing. We are preparing for the weaving looms and also for other things. And our big advantage is quality and productivity. Our machines are able to run fabrics which are not able on other machines. So it's not a question of speed, it's at least a question of quality, article and performance and production, value of production.
Always a good chance, good opportunity to do networking, to meet other suppliers, to exchange information. And our focus for our lecture this time was to give more information about the electronic pattern control, which we have introduced on our HKS4 MEL and the ML multibar lay series. This is the main focus.
We from the beaming preparation want to inform about the latest technologies in sectional warping, and here we give also a report about existing machines which are in the market since the last 10 years and the latest developments designs.
These are the two main exhibitions that we have worldwide. We are now in the last stages for ITMA Asia. We are shipping out the new machines, the new developments, and Karlmayr is always presenting new machines. And as I said before, we will show products on the price performance topic, but also we will show, especially in the lace field, a machine which can create a new application, a new fabric, and we are very much looking forward for ITMA Asia. ITMA Milano is still a little bit away because the focus is on ITMA Asia, but you can be sure that Karlmayr will also show some innovations during that exhibition.
In beaming preparation, you can be sure that Karlmayr also will show innovations, but it's not the right time to give you details for this.